problem solved. Listen to all the people on the left, if you're down with every breath, help me out, shout it out, oh yeah.
Brought to you by FBM, Duff's, Red Bull, and all the other sponsors.
So get over to registration and get yourself a beer.
Yeah, DJ Mr. Man. All up in the Hoosier State, baby. Third frame, right guy and D Deluxe, baby. Let's go. Mary,
put it down on us.
We talking about that. You know
how we do. Mary,
describe the jump setup here today.
It's basically, we're trying to bring pedaling back into BMX and eliminate scootering around like a sloth. So basically, it's start down the street at the corner store, pedal your balls off, and one jump, no chump, gear up. Gear up if you're going to show up. Pretty psyched when it's like you clear the jump and the crowd goes crazy. That's how it should be.
Dave King, tell us a little bit about these jumps, man.
I did all the elevation comps, and we took all the ideas from elevation, like the big downhill roll-ins and all that, and pretty much canceled it all out and went back to our roots, which sucks. This is way not fun. It's awesome, though. I love it.
Yeah, how would you describe the setup, man?
I'd say a good old power wheelie, white knuckle, grin your teeth, and just huck that shit.
Those kids are aping it. They're just going for it. They're like, 22 foot double. All right, let's send it.
No business. I'm here at the Brawling at the Belmar contest with Ed, the guy who owns the bar. And what's your take out here today?
Awesome. Can't believe it turned out so well. The weather held up. A couple of people actually landed the jumps. Phenomenal.
What inspired you guys to like want to do this contest out here?
Harrison came up to me and asked me if I'd be interested. And I was drunk at the time, so I said, yeah, this is what happened.
You scared out here at all for these kids?
Oh, terrified, yeah.
Thank you very much for letting us come out here.
Oh, thank you for having us.
JP, describe the scene.
We've definitely created a time warp here. Could be anywhere from 93 to 97.
Yeah, name off some of the legends here today.
The one and only Isaac Groundchuck McRae is here. Bar Spiniak is here. Stig is here. Superfly is here. Dunny is here. Dunny and Ice Money. It's a good mix of new school and old school kooks.
Okay, I'm standing here with Ice Money. Ice, where have you been?
Doing big things, training, making things happen.
You still in on the pro circuit, or are you just kind of taking it easy?
I'm still on it.
You gonna party at all?
No doubt.
All right, bud. All right. I heard you. Ton. That's why I call you my hun, cause when I'm rolling with you, counting money with my honey's kinda funny to do. And yo, we love to get blue, and yo, we love to. We're here with Isaac McRae. Isaac, how do you describe the dirt jump here today?
Dirt jump is very nice, very nice. You know, it's very old school. The path sucks, so that's very old school too.
I saw you out here jumping this thing. How did it treat you?
Not well. I pretty much bitch slapped my fat ass down to the ground. I didn't have a snowball's chance in hell clearing that thing.
Describe the scene out here today.
A lot of guys missing sleeves with headbands and women's pants. Young kids out here, you got the Baker boys with their mohawks. It's a great scene, you know.
What's your name?
Yeah, my name is Dennis.
Dennis, you were killing it out there and you're killing yourself. What was your technique out there today?
Technique was just like hauling ass and then f***ing your ass up.
Buddy, it was a sight, I'll tell you that. What do you think about that dude just like basically humping that landing?
He already had a bleeding face and then he actually ate part of the landing. We don't condone riding drunk, but I'm pretty sure that kid was a little bit buzzed.
That dude is out of his mind. I think he's got the lens cap on. Holy shit. I cannot believe it. Ryan Foster! What possessed you with this outfit?
1995 was a good year.
Heard you used to paint bikes at Cyclocrop.
I did.
I'm here with Steve Crandall. What kind of goal did you like want to achieve by doing this contest?
I just want to see how many like people would come to a bar and have fun, drink beer, and just like hoot and holler for their buddies riding. I don't know, I was just psyched to see everyone having a good time. Like, even when dudes were just clearing it, the whole crowd was just going apeshit. It was awesome.
Describe the jump today.
It's vicious.
Did you like it?
I loved it.
Ryan Guler, how would you compare this contest to any other regular dirt jumping contest?
It's so different. I'd see people do run-ups and almost get bitten by dogs.
Who do you want to see win?
The Cobra.
The Cobra? Who's the Cobra?
The kid from Australia.
He's a pretty sweet dude. He's missing teeth, though.
I know.
What's your favorite highlight of the day?
Throwing up before my run and after my run.
Have you been drinking?
No, last night. Big one.
I got three words for you. Nice. Who's your favorite rider today?
Dad.
What's the craziest thing you've ever seen your dad do?
Eat pig brains.
Oh my God, I just wet myself. You just made me wet myself.
I don't know if I'm comfortable with that, but I'll take it.
It's cool, man.
See how high that was?
Buddy, what's your name?
Jeff Slaughter.
You're an ape.
Thanks.
Yeah. Cigarette in his mouth. Like it was nothing. Didn't even lose the cigarette. Buddy, you're gonna try that again.
Maybe Marissa's kind of dulled.
Well, I pretty much called you out. Ryan Guler is not scared. Jeez. Are you going to try to enter the contest today, or are you just out here watching?
I think I'm a little too old for that, bro.
Nah, you're never
too old.
A young with a laid back tongue. The aim is to succeed and achieve at 21. Just like ringling mothers, I'll daze and astound. Captivate the masters, the pose is profound. Do it for the strong, we do it for the meek. booming and you're booming and you're booming in your Jeep or your Honda or your Beamer or your Legend or your Benz. The rave of the town to your foes and your friends. So push it along, trails we blaze. Don't deserve the gong, don't deserve the praise. The tranquility will make you unball your fist while we put hip hop on a brand new twist. A brand new twist with a whole heap of mystic. So low key that you probably missed it. But yet it's so loud that it stands in the crowd. When the guy takes the beat, they bow. So raise up, squire, adjust your attire. We have no time to wallow in the mire. If you're on a foreign path, then let me do the lead. Join in the essence of the cool out breed. You cool out to the music, cause it makes you feel serene. With the birds and the bees and all those groovy things. Like getting stomach aches when you gotta go to work. Or staring into space when you're feeling berserk. I don't really mind if it's over your head.
My name is JJ Palmier. I'm 20 years old from Levittown, Pennsylvania. I ride for Nike, Premium, Little Devil, and Staff Mail Order. And I'd like to thank Mark Losey at Nike, everyone at Premium, Derek and Sean at Little Devil, Bob at Staff, my dad and my friends for keeping me motivated to ride, and props for giving me this bio.
Hi, I'm Adam 22, owner of the Come Up, and I got a bunch of my dudes together for the Come Up DOTC trip.
I think of all the good times that I've wasted having good times.
When I was fighting, I could have done the right thing. All of that boozing, I was really losing. Good time. Good time.
Welcome to the United Bike Trip.
Caleb Kilby, I live in Hastings, England, and I'm 21 years of age.
Corey Martinez from Decatur, Alabama, 24 years old.
Hello, I'm Ricky Fever, I'm 20 year old, from Rotherham in England.
My name is Ryan Metro, I'm 21 years old, and I'm from Louisville, Kentucky. My
name's Nathan Williams, 19 years old, from Nashville, Tennessee.
My name's Ian Morris, I'm 37 years old, I'm from Hastings, England.
Hi, I'm Leo Forte, 20 years old, from Devon, England.
My name's Ethan Thurman, I'm 32 years old, from Louisville, Kentucky.
Hi,
I'll be a chauffeur for the United team on this trip.
Trip started down in Louisville, rode some street.
You know, I got to take these guys to some spots that I've been looking at for a while and never been able to do anything on. Took the guys to the kinked rail, real steep, and you know, Caleb got the ice, busted it out, and then out of nowhere, Nathan did a gap to T-hang on it first go, like it was nothing. Just next to that was a real steep rail. Ian came blowing out of the building, straight down it.
Ricky did a foot jam whip on this roof. I don't even know what it was. It was just a weird sculpture. I don't know. It was just random. That was good.
So our friend Bruno just saw this gap.
He tried to bunny up over his 3-foot wall to about 12-foot drop.
Tried it 5 or 6 times, just blew up every time.
One time, the bike bounced so far, it just nearly hit Stu. That was pretty funny. He was really good, but he just blew up most of the time, but he kept on trying it until his body gave up. But that guy's crazy.
After Louisville was over, we headed down to Nashville.
Pretty wild scene, good street spot, enough bums. we met a sweet dude called Kevin. When we first met Kevin, you know, he's a little hazy. He wasn't really making much sense. I think he was tweaking a little. He was just chilling out, watching us ride.
Took him, you know, probably 15, 20 minutes to say his first words, but after that, he was in with us.
Towards the end, he started to sober up. Kevin was a good guy, really, you know. He was my buddy. Ricky Feather did a pretty wild wall ride down some stairs. It must have been about 16 stairs, pretty huge. It's a wild drop.
Just busted it out first go.
That was really impressive.
Yeah, so after we rode street, we headed up to Nashville Concrete Park, which is really good. And it's a pretty wild scene there, to be honest. We turned up and the park was just full of drunks.
Two drunk girls stand out in my mind, just trashy looking, knees busted up, and their teeth were glowing orange from the sparks they had.
I think the quote was, "I've only had one spark, but I did just have a baby," which was pretty special to me.
See, I only drank one spark. Okay. I also just had a baby.
Oh, that's
so
cute.
Loving it. I don't know what was going on there. I can't even describe it, you just have to live it.
Definitely a different scene to what I'm used to.
After Nashville, we went to Little Rock.
I've never been to Little Rock before, but Corrigan's hometown, he's talked to me about it a lot, and it's just full of really good spots to ride.
Metro did a pretty sick double peg up and over at the top of the rail. He called out the ice and I think he was sweating it for a minute. He didn't know what he got himself in for, but he busted it. Like, it was legit. That was unbelievable.
Oh yeah.
Another day, another clip.
That's all, let's do it, you know. So getting down in the town, it makes no
sound. Leo did this big gap to war ride from this flat bank. That was really, really good. That was like a kind of Reuben style gap to war ride. I was pretty impressed with that. That was really nice. We'll be right back.
Caleb spotted a really nice manual ledge and just went for it, true Caleb style, fast as hell. He busted it out and he literally missed it by an inch, ended up sliding ice pick down it. It was a pretty heavy shoulder slide. He got worked on it, but he was happy anyway, it's a good clip. Caleb also spotted a really gnarly out rail over a big set of stairs. We went there early in the day and he hurt himself a little, so he had to pack it in. So we headed back there one night and lit the scene up and rode it again.
And that took like a good hour to do, but he took a lot of slams, but he got it finally done in the end at 3 a.m.
We found a sweet rail. There was these sketchy stoppers on it, like, so Nathan stepped in. He wanted to bust down it, so and the first time he went down it, about three of them busted off. So with a little bit of gentle persuasion, we knocked a few more off, and he busted down it, and it was a serious rail all the way to the bottom, and then three the stairs after, which were huge as well. That was a sweet line. With a bit of team effort, he'd done it.
Post office rail has been sessioning so much. One night we went back and Nathan was wanting a 180 over it, and sure enough he fires it out once and just ends up getting killed, and then goes back for it again. Just got worked even more, like just so hard.
It's too gnarly, he got spent.
After about two or three days in Little Rock, we got back on the bus and we drove to Corey's house to ride his local park, which is High Wheel Skate Park. It's just a wild scene. It's like a house, which is a bike shop and has a ramp in the back.
Scrapyard just across the road and
signs everywhere saying like, don't shoot trespassers, and
it's random.
The ramps are kind of sketchy, so it made for a good time. There's not a lot there, it's just two mini ramps, but we had really good fun, you know. Everyone enjoyed it, good scene.
Seth Kimbrough actually came out and rode with us, and that was awesome, we got to see him ride.
When we showed up, it looked like the ramps needed a little bit of maintenance.
Seth were there, like hammering nails into the ramps to keep the coping down with a piece of 2x4, taking the nails out of the box jump. It was wild, really. I saw him one time double peg up the quarter pipe, straight into a piece of steel sticking out, like straight over the bars.
Pretty different sort of style of building ramps, you know? It seemed to work.
After High Wheels, we drove to Huntsville Concrete Park for a late night session.
On the way to Birmingham, we stopped off and picked up Leland and Marcus.
And this morning, me and Marcus Grubbs kind of flew into Birmingham to meet up with the rest of the crew. Well, we couldn't make it for the whole trip, so because we have real jobs at home.
Hey, everybody!
Never met Marcus before. Real cool kid.
And then we went to Birmingham, Alabama.
Our friend Barlow, he took us some ghetto trannies.
It was just wild quarter pipe in the middle of nowhere.
Which really good fun, actually. Really tight, sort of steep tranny. Bunch of little ghetto kids who wanted to sort of ride everyone's bikes and stuff.
Ryan Fudger, aka Fudge Fudge, letting some of the little hood rats ride his bike around.
At first, everyone was a little bit sketched by it, but they were good kids and everyone sort of let them have a go on their bikes and stuff, and it was good fun. You know, it's good to see other cultures and stuff, so it's pretty interesting.
Quite a cool scene.
Downtown Ricky Feather was in action. He was absolutely loving it. He was in his element with all the bro dogs.
Ricky Feather's my boy.
He's shackering up.
Sup?
He was there with his boys, yeah. Loving it. Then we drove back down to Nashville again because we had a really good ride there, so we thought we'd check out some more spots.
Went back to the concrete park. That was a good time, you know, hanging out, chilling.
Did another late nighter in Nashville, living the vampire lifestyle. Went and checked out some street spots. Metro found a mental rail. It's just the longest rail I've ever seen. So he tried it a few times and sort of had a few little busts, but he managed to get down it in the end, and it was pretty nuts, really. It's a big rail.
Seth did this real high rail. It was man-sized. It had kind of this tree at the bottom, and he did it perfect first go.
Caleb found a really nice manual ledge, which was high and steep with a pretty gnarly kink on the end. Manualed that, and then Ricky decided he wanted to feeble down it, which is pretty insane. He's got no pegs, so it's a pedal feeble, and this kink at the end was pretty gnarly, and it was spitting him off every time. But yeah, he managed to get down it, and it was pretty cool.
Not like that.
Yeah, drove back up to Louisville after that.
Homeward bound, took their home away from home in Louisville, Kentucky, back to my house.
Ended up riding the concrete park again there, which is awesome. I could ride that place forever. So now the trip's over and I'm probably gonna have a barbecue at Metro's place and say our goodbyes. I think it's been really great to see the English come over and just kind of experience the Southland over here. All the different people that we've met on this trip is just unbelievable. The crazy people, the kooks, man. Like,
I don't think the English guys know how to deal with the good old hometown Southern culture. There might be a little bit of weirdos, strange homeless people.
It's a bit different to the UK. Seen some wild people at every single stop we've made.
I kind of had an idea what to expect, but I was completely wrong. It's too wild out here. Anything goes. Nothing surprises me anymore. It's wacky.
I love it. Absolutely love it.
It's been awesome. It's been good times.
Like, thank Ian Morris and the United Bike Company team for a good time. It's Lee Thurman with Props Visual. United Bike Trip. So long.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, and we're getting around. That was fat.
Alright, fortunately, Red Bull have built the most amazing slopestyle course ever and flown in 30 of the top pros in the world to ride it. Unfortunately, because we're in England, it's chucking it down with rain and nobody can ride there. Fortunately, Kai Forte has his own personal barn that he's been put together, so we've all shipped down and you're going to get to check it out. It's pretty cool, especially for England.
here at the Red Bull Empire of Dirt, well, Plan B, with one of the main sort of organisers and the guy who built the jumps, Kai Forte. Do you want to tell us a bit why we're not actually in Rabbit's Farm and we're down here at Decoy?
Basically, just the rain just came in, held up pretty well for like a day, and then the second day the rain was so strong it just washed everything into the bottoms and just pretty much ruined everything we'd done. Just unrepairable, really. Bit gutted, but luckily like our spot's not far down the road, so just moved everyone here for a chilled Saturday session pretty much.
And that things quite clearly didn't go as planned, but you still been having a good time?
Yeah, it's been real good. These trails are real fun, and any trip that includes trails is fine by me.
You plan on coming back next year for the event if it happens again?
Yeah, this is a good one. I don't miss these. I can miss a detour. This is the good stuff here.
yeah. Are you ready for this now? You have just witnessed the steering wheel spin by one of the finest bicyclists you will ever see. It's a new thing. You seen it first at William Penn High School on G's Terror Dome. Cameraman, hold it and drop it like it's hot when it's ready.
What's your take on the contest today?
It's wonderful. Only with us.
I paid for that. We're done with this interview. Buddy, have a sip of this.
Go again. Heading to the liquor store.
Come on, man, chill with that. I paid for it. Deuce, what was the highlight today?
Today it was either Ryan Gutler's double backflips or waking up in a puddle of piss. I pissed in your bed.
Score Martinez. Let's have one more.
What's up with this tie-dye t-shirt you got on, man? Life's a beach style right here, man.
You guys are at the Belmar. I'm at the comfort zone. Like, I'm feeling good.
Was you one of the elusive crew that made it down to the bottom? Did you get enough time or not?
No comment.
Metro, what are you doing?
So, is that guacamole going to be a new colorway?
Number one or number two? Number one or number two?
Good old John Smith, extra smooth, and old blue. Life-changing experience.
No shit.
All right, I'm here with two of the cutest looking girls here today. What's your guys' name?
My name is Riley. Marilyn.
Are you guys drinking a lot of Kool-Aid and fruit juice today?
Yeah.
What about Ice Money? You guys know Ice Money?
Yeah. No.
Your dog farts and smells, dude. But she's a cute dog.
Yeah.
She's killer cute and nice all in the same time.
She's just chilling.
We saw Rooftop there, which was random. I think he was going to try and backflip the Tennessee River or something, but...
Grind that bad boy. Yeah.
I'm in Tom Corleone. I'm the best ever done it. Two track. Fuck. Baby, you're here. Baby, you're here. Shake my behind. Shake my behind. Move your behind. Shake my behind. And I'm rocking, baby. I'm rocking. I'm rocking. Shake your body, shake your body, shake your body. Don't go the way. I'm the coolest. I'm the coolest. I'm the coolest. Look at what they call it on. Baby, yeah. I do it like this. And I'm leaving you. Going on leaving the building. Nah, look like you have on your team. Going on leaving the building.